Now, I understand that people want to silence others, that people want to rhetorically say, don't you talk to me because, you know, of this. But what astonishes me is that this is clearly fallacious, and yet I never, never see this pointed out as an example of logical fallacy. Now, what is the name of this logical fallacy? That's the wrong side. Yep. Yeah, I think you shouted it. It's argumentum ad hominem, quite clearly. The person is being... I was going to say silence, but let's not focus on silence. The person is being responded to in terms of an identification of them as being in a certain group. Right? You're saying something about them or about a group that they're in instead of what they've actually said. And this is textbook argumentum ad hominem. It's incredible, but I never see this, or I never hear this pointed out. The victims of this type of tactic always argue in other terms. They say, well, I'm not that privileged because of this, you know. It's just this big mess. It's a huge big mess. It's very difficult to untangle all these things and get to the issues. So what I say is, don't untangle it. Don't talk about the issues themselves, because the issues have now flown out the window. The person has decided to silence you, and don't even accuse them of silencing you either. That's another point. Don't even mention that, because they say, no, but I am listening to you, and, you know, blah, blah, blah. There's always an excuse for this fallacy. Just mention the fallacy. Just point out, I have made a point, and you have responded by saying I'm in a certain group, or describing some characteristic of me. That is argumentum ad hominem. That is fallacious. And focus on that. Point out that their entire argument is fallacious. It is textbook argumentum ad hominem. The discussion cannot proceed while that sort of thing goes on.
No facilities, cause some don't agree with how I do this. I get straight and meditate like a Buddhist. I'm dropping flavor, my behavior is hereditary, but my technique is very necessary. Blame it on Ice Cube, because it's steady getting funky. When you got a subject and a predicate, add it on a dope beat, and it'll make you think. Don't be another sequel.
Check your privilege, white privilege, being told to check your privilege, as I say in the title, stops equality completely. Because when you tell someone to check their privilege, you're basically telling that person that at no point in time can they identify to you on any level. That they are either above you or maybe even beneath you to an extent. And you cannot see eye to eye on anything because there's that element of what you perceive as being privilege standing between you, them, and an open discussion. That it shuts down the conversation completely because they can't handle what you're saying. And because they can't handle what you're saying, even if you come at it from a logistical logical mindset, and you represent your statement in short, you know, segments with facts and evidence and stories to back up your claims. They look at it from an emotional aspect and shut you down. And that's effectively what happens when you tell someone to check your privilege. You know, like I was watching that video from the Portland Trayvon rally yesterday, and the girl gets up there and she's like, "You white people need to check your privilege every day."
I want to say something to you, white people. It is not enough to feel bad. It is not enough to not be a bigot. Because if you are not actively dismantling white supremacy and checking your privilege every single day...
What? really? Like, okay, you know, like, I've worked in the ghetto. I've gone to the ghetto on jobs. I've been told that I'm going to be shot because I'm white. I'm told that I can't walk around that neighborhood because I'm white and I'll be hurt. Because people are going to want to attack me for that. For the color of my skin. Which is just, so, is effectively, I've experienced racism in that regard. But because I'm white, I can't experience racism. And when you want to have the discussion of equality, equality is much like respect. It has to be earned and not given. And that's my true belief on the subject, is people who demand respect and demand equality generally deserve neither.
If you would shut the fuck up for the 50th billionth time, you're just too busy hating women. You can't fucking see that we're trying to actually work on those same situations.
Then why are you part of the organization?
Saying that we're trying to take away their rights? How are we trying to take away their rights?
Why?
Can you shut the fuck up for a second, too? Bullshit, you hate sexism, but you're an MRA. Okay, no, point taken. We win.
Obviously, haven't read our
letter. Nobody doesn't want to hear what we're actually here for, so you just want to not talk over me?
You're not actually
wearing a
about, okay? The idea of certain people are inherently more valuable than other people because of superficial physical attributes is part of patriarchy. I don't know if you're noticing a theme with patriarchy.
Yeah, you keep yelling.
Anyway, I'm not done.
What gives you the right and power to define what rape is?
No, it's not a true reality. You don't get to define what a true reality is.
Getting back to the PG, that's program, and it's easy. Dre is back, new jacks are made hollow. Expressing ain't the subject because they like to follow the words, the style, the trend. The records are spinning again and again and again. Yo, you're on the other end. Watch your brother blend, dope rhymes with no help. There's no fessing or guessing while I'm expressing myself. It's crazy to see people be what society wants them to be, but not me. Ruthless is the way to go, they know. Others say rhymes which fail to be original, or they kill where the hip-hop starts. Forget about the ghetto and rap for the pop charts. Though some musicians, cuz at home, they're scared to use profanity when up on the microphone. Yeah, they want reality, but you hear none. They'd rather exaggerate a little fiction. Some say no to drugs and take a stand, but after the show, they go looking for the dope man. Or they ban my group from the radio here in WA and say hell no. But you know it ain't all about wealth, as long as you make a note to spread the sound.
And when someone says to you, I disagree with this statement because here are my thoughts, you can just, instead of going, well, you need to check your privilege and shutting down the conversation, which is a lot of times what social justice warriors and feminists do because they can't actually back this stuff up with anything more than feelings, that you shut down the argument completely and you're not able to have that. And yeah, I know I may come across as being similar in that regard, but I'm saying that I'm willing to have that debate. I put that debate on the table. I say, let's discuss this. Let's talk about this. Let's work through this. And then I get told to check my privilege. And then I'm not for equality. But then they don't realize the hypocrisy of what they're doing and how if you tell someone to check their privilege, effectively you're telling them that you don't want equality because they will never be equal to you. You will never be equal to them because you won't let them identify with you even though they're trying, which is sad.
Okay, so that happens. Does that happen frequently within the media? Does that happen all the time?
It happens enough that you'll find at least enough results on the
list. Some statistics. Enough. How often does it happen? That something like that, some bizarre circumstance.
To borrow a phrase, you just use the purpose in the
pudding. So this is what this is.
in terms of how things work, it's basically telling me that I can't experience anything on the same level as you. We can't have an open discussion about this because you don't want to have that discussion or that debate. You want to hold that over me because you want to feel empowered by it. And she's like, no, you're wrong. And I'm like, I'm not. You're telling me I can't feel something, or you're invalidating my feels, is something that is discrimination, is prejudice, you're telling me that because you're black, I'm white, you're being racist. No, white people can't experience racism. I'm like, all right, well, we obviously have to agree to disagree here and be done. That is that.
You're white male cis world, yes, but
if we're able to agree that there are certain commonalities, obviously there are differences, but if we focus on the commonalities, would have that been more productive?
How are we going to get rid of racism and
stop talking about it? I'm going to stop calling you a white man.
Yeah.
And I'm going to ask you to stop calling me a black man.